Oh, we got some viewers. Hey guys, how's it going? How's everybody's evening going? I'm really fucking tired. Just been working on this track today. It's like the next release. Winter Festival, I don't know, probably not, I'm not sure. Oh, the tour was cool. Yeah, I'm glad to be home. I've been wanting to work on this track for like a while. Here, I'll show you guys. Yeah, like it's kind of a little bit snappy right now. Like, trying to fix it. So where is everybody from? What are you guys doing? What are you up to? Tell me some shit. I'm super bored. Like, this thing, I've been banging my head against it for like, I don't know, about 6 hours, and I'm kind of bored of it now, so I'm looking for a distraction. That's why we're here. Five a.m. in Australia. Holy shit, dude! Wow, dude, that's late. Oh yeah, good luck on that remix, then, dude. I mean, there's been a lot of pretty decent ones come through, so the competition's doing good. I actually started something today that's a little bit like Miss You. Yeah. I'm going to start doing this more often because I realize that doing this and just kind of working away, I get to feel like I have company, except I don't have to actually interact with any people. It's great. Thank you guys. Stop being so nice to me, everybody. I need to feel like I'm terrible, and so that I work harder. Thank you, Constantine. You get it. You get it. You got that shit. I think it's okay. A double drop. Diversify this. Nah, probably not. I mean, not anytime soon anyway, just because I've got so much other stuff I should be working on that I'm not. Excuse me. Yeah. I should probably sort out the second drop. Germany. Actually, I think that might happen sooner than anybody would have expected. I did get a call today that might now be in Germany soonish. So, watch that space. No. Oh, the phone's going. Doesn't matter. Rampage was sick. I guess that means shout out to Mr. Faint, because back to back things. UK, yeah, we're actually home. We're gonna do a couple more UK ones this year, I believe. Well, not this year, next year. Which is good, because that doesn't happen anywhere near as much as it should, you know? Do I like nuggets? Everybody likes nuggets, don't they? I feel like, yeah, most people like nuggets. Hey, everybody. Hey, everyone who's still, like, joining in. Yeah. Will I come to Chile? I'd love to go to Chile. Yeah, that's not Chile, sorry, Chile. Yeah. I'd love to, but it's not up to me most of the time. It's just up to like promoters, and they ask me, and then I say yeah. Lighthouse VIP. Which one? There's like two now. I'll be right back. I just need to fix something. I'll be right back. One second. Ah. All right. We're all good. All good. I realized I'd left the oven on. Do I speak Spanish? No, I don't, but I would love to learn. I'm actually, at the beginning of this last tour, I downloaded, I downloaded an app so that I could learn Spanish, and then, I found myself forgetting to use it, but I really want to, like, Spanish, like, is the language I think I'm gonna learn if I learn any, so, I'd love to be able to. What brand apple? So today, I usually eat Fuji apples or Fiji apples. I forget what they're fucking called, but they don't have any. My local like shop has stopped selling them, so I've had to resort to Pink Ladies, which is a massive shame. Horrible. Pray for me. Hmm. I'm gonna copy some shit across on here, I think. So how many of you guys here are producers yourselves? Like, I feel like that's kind of common for there to be producers liking producers and coming to hang out, these sort of things. Does anybody here know anything about the LUF stuff that they've been doing for Spotify metering and shit? Because I'm trying to master this thing, and I don't want to master it too loud. No, I don't know where Eric's two lead shows are. Sorry, dude. How similar are these? Oh, basically exactly the same. Fuck it. Right. Yeah, I'll show you guys the track I'm working on right now. So I bounced it all down to audio and trying to fix it today. I'm pretty happy with it too. I think I could push the limit harder. Let me try. That's okay. See, everyone's saying 12 dB minus 12 lufs, right? I tried that. It's already at that without being limited. So, I don't know what the fuck to do. Yeah. It goes to, like, minus 9 if I, like, leave it just at headroom. So, I don't know. I don't really get this whole lefts thing. Seems like a. I don't know. I don't know what it seems like, but I don't like it. Okay. There's just so many different ways of metering, like, sound now. And I guess lufts must take into consideration, like, the perceived loudness curve, like, that humans, like, we hear two noises that are exactly the same volume. If one of them is higher pitched, it'll sound louder to us. So a lot of people in the last few years have been taking a lot of bass out of their mixdowns and putting loads of, like, scratchy high end in there. And that can really work. But, yeah, I don't know if it's necessary. So there's had to be, like, I guess metering types that take that into consideration. I'm not sure. That's what I assume lufts is something to do with. Sorry, I'm nerding out right now. And, like, I guess about, like, 80% of you guys are just, like, shut up and talk about something cool. I should read some of these messages. That's the spirit, Shay. That's the spirit, man. Yeah, I mean, I don't really want to know. Because at the end of the day, if it sounds good, it sounds good. That's really reductive, but it's all that really matters. Like, there's a load of tracks that I really love that are mastered super, super, super loud. And then maybe Spotify would crush the shit out of them or just turn them down loads. But I think that's fine, you know? Doesn't bother me. Can't imagine it bothers many people, apart from the people who made the track. Is that done? My next release date, I don't know. This isn't the next release, but I think it's a release after that. That's why I'm doing it now. Do I regret releasing a song? Yeah, all the time. That's because I kind of wish I was making more vocal stuff, but a lot of what I have to do so that I can still get booked for shows and stuff is write really, really heavy shit that's maybe not so approachable, we'll say. And it sounds like people screaming instead of anything else. Thank you, guys. Kind words. Seriously, thank you so much. There's a difference between those two. What is it? What rank am I in league? Right now I'm plat 5. I decayed at the end of the season because I was on tour. Headlights. There's one of the things I've been doing for the last, like, year or so is I've been working on a load of tracks that no one's ever actually heard, apart from, like, the people working on them. And they're all completely, like, vocal based. I see there's a lot of you guys there just saying that you want to hear more vocals, and that's definitely going to happen. I promise that. It's a really nice apple. You're right, Haley. It's a gorgeous apple. I might get a second one. I might go fucking crazy. DNPEP isn't like dead, it's just it's been turned into singles. One second, I'm gonna get another apple. Haley's got me needing another apple. Everything's falling over. Hey. How's it going? Your music's always... I was high when you were just starting up. Oh, you were in high. You, I misread that completely. Yeah, to anybody who's been listening to my music for a while, like, thank you so much. You've been able to give me a job, pretty much. Yeah. Yep. Haley's got it. More future bounce stuff coming up. Yeah, I'm super bored of this mix, Dan. I'm gonna work on something else. I might work on that house tune that I should be working on, actually. What's it called? Yeah. You know, Fox Stevenson snapback. We've never made any hats. Maybe we should make hats. Who would want a Fox Stevenson hat? Is that something you guys are interested in? That's the one. Yeah, I'm done with that mixdown for today. I'm tempted to do a couple more of those sort of acoustic things, just because I don't know. People seem to like them. Oh, I got sun bleached. I'm so sorry, Callum. Dude, gotta be careful with your clothes. I've shrunk so many shirts this year, and it's been heartbreaking. I'm there with you, man. When you ruin your own shit. I do listen to upcoming producers, but I don't spend a huge amount of time on that just because I don't get time to do much of anything. Like the last 2 months, I've just been kind of traveling and sleeping and playing shows, which is great, but you know, there's more to life than that, right? I'm curious about how much of a delay there is between when I say something when you guys can hear it. So when you hear me say this, could you just type now? And then I've got kind of like an idea. Because then if I'm like waiting for replies from somebody or whatever. I don't have any peanut butter. I would love to. That would be great. Okay, so it's like 30 seconds-ish. That's quite a long time. That's no good. I'm kind of lost at what to do. What do you guys think we should do here? We got, you know, we got about 200 people hanging out. What should we do? D&B works in progress. Yeah, fucking tons of them. Always. Short delay, no. I'm trying to, like, I'm gonna see if there's any, like, cool ways to make dubstep happy again. That would be really nice. I've been, like... Pick a track and I'll remaster it? Fuck. Right now? I've just been mixing and mastering all day. I don't think I could do that right now. This is something I started like in bed last night. I'm hearing it for the first time again. I wonder if there's actually any merit in that. Maybe it'd be better as a jump up track. Huh. Let's try that. Try it as a jump up track. It's a massive guilty pleasure, but I've been really, really into jump up drum and bass recently. Like, more so than I ever thought I ever could. It's, yeah. A little embarrassing, actually. what's that like? 174. Yeah, I'm not sure. I'm not sure about that. I'm at a massive loss on, like, what I want to work on at the moment. You guys stop typing things, so I'm run out of, like, things to reply to. Not great. Turn the light off. Nah, much nicer. Vibier. Are you guys still there? The last thing I can see is someone saying that they're jealous. Now, it's gone all quiet. Oh. I can see it on the computer now. We're good. I'm just gonna start to reply here. It's weird. I've seen myself. Look, feedback. Ooh. That's a horrible angle. I didn't realize how terrible I looked. Not better? Fuck. That's much better. Now I look less horrible. okay. No, I'm not playing that track. Maybe we could just make a track together right now. That might be a cool idea. First, I want to play you guys something I was working on recently, actually. This is something I'm working on at the moment. There's some nice colours for you guys to look at now. Funny about this track is the moment you get rid of like that top sound, I think it's this one. The moment you get rid of that, the track sounds really, really fucking casual. Check this out. It's just really like, makes it like completely, completely casual and boring. Then you bring it back in. Zoom in on my face. Alright, fuck. So I can't read the comments without coming in on here. Apparently, so the comments and shit have stopped refreshing on my phone for whatever reason. So I've got to check on the computer for that. And yeah, anybody asking, those are my vocals. There has never been a track of mine as of yet, and I don't know if I plan on ever doing it, that will feature anything but my own vocals. I a little bit, I don't know, not superstitious, but it's just like, you know, it's part of what I like to do as a musician. And for a long time, a lot of people were like, fucking stop doing that shit. And now what it's like is if I do a track without vocals, there's like a load of comments saying, oh, where are the vocals? And it's awesome. But yeah, it's that whole part of what I do has always been a little bit of it's definitely been tumultuous would be the word I would go for, I guess. I do need to work on something, but I don't know what yet. I gotta check those comments. This is so annoying that I gotta check them. Oh, laptop! There we go. I gotta check those comments. Ah, no! No! I don't wanna hear myself. Fuck that. Oh, Adam's here! Adam, how you doing, man? It's been a while. I've been loving the piano stuff you've been doing. If you guys don't know who Adam Tell is, you need to, because he's awesome and an amazing musician. Just saying. Where are we? You know what? Adam, throw up a link to like to your favorite one of your EPs, and I'll make sure people say, stop. Oh. Okay. So, I'm just trying to figure out a way to be able to see these comments now, because they're not refreshing anymore. Right, that should do it. Awesome. What have I been working on recently that's really cool? Oh, that was kind of cool. At this point, it's devolved from me doing a mixdown and you guys keeping me company to I'm just going to play a load of stuff that I'm working on, and we're going to hang out and say hi. Yep. And my computer doesn't seem to want to load the things. Okay, so it's refreshing that all at the top. That's awesome. Okay. Am I looking for? Oh, I'm really looking forward to playing the Netsky Subquake show. That's going to be a really cool one. Yeah. Discord session 2. No, it's not going to be like that. I was doing this mixdown for this track, which I guess most of you were here for when I had that up. And I found myself kind of losing my mind just a little bit. Tiny bit. It sounds good, and I'm not unhappy with it, but there's just some tiny little, really, like, if any of you guys have done mixdowns before, then you know that it's horrible when, in music, if it's super close to being right, but some little things are really getting to you, those are the hardest things to change, usually, because everything else kind of holds up each other, and that's kind of how mixing music works. And then, so if you start changing anything to change these small things, you start ruining the things you like about it. And then an hour later, you listen to what you did an hour before, and it's like, wow, I just wasted the last hour of my life. And I really don't want to do that. So this is something I've been working on. I haven't done a vocal for it yet, but I want to, and I think it's going to be a kind of cool track. This is, I think I'm going to call this Not a Good Person. Just that.
cool bit later on where we had like loads of strings, and it makes that section sound really like, I don't know, uplifting and pretty. This bit. I want to vocal that one soon.
I think if I got the vocal right, it would be a really cool song, as opposed to like dance track, because it's not that droppy, because the drop just kind of happens. Also, hey, Melissa, I see you. Melissa is one of my managers, and she's very happy that I'm doing this completely impromptu, and sent me a text a few seconds ago. I'm hoping I'm not going to spill anything that I'm not supposed to talk about, because that would not be okay, right? Apparently, I'm also getting ill. Man, it's been a long 2 months. Go to Tomorrowland. I've been to Tomorrowland twice, and it was pretty great. Had a great time. What's my favorite song and artist? Ooh, recently, thanks, Mel. Recently, I've been listening to this band called Nothing But Thieves. I think they're really fucking cool. Do I have any of their stuff on here? Yeah, but it's like rock. Like, they're like a rock band from London, and they've been doing some really cool shit, if you ask me. Yeah. I love this shit. Yeah, Nothing But Thieves. This is called Amsterdam. It's fucking sick. Yo, actually, I should totally remix this. That's a fucking great idea. Oh, I'm gonna get on that. See if I can do that. Sick track. Sick track. Fucking sick tune. Ugh. Do not check Discord. The shit hive. I think I might get my own like Discord together where I can talk to people and say hi. I'm gonna try to find a better place to keep this camera. Cause, oh, maybe I can balance it on my compressor. No. That's not gonna work either. How about if I do that? No, that's not gonna work. That's a lot better. That's a lot better. Now I'm like chilling. It feels like an actual live stream now. I'm not gonna move from this point, I think. We've got like my Cat and Crows vinyls and all the shit that I just kind of brought home. I haven't unpacked yet. I've been home like 2 days since being in America for like 2 months. And then I had to go to London, and I think I've slept in my bed like once in like in the last 2 months, I guess. Comes with the territory. Yeah, things are falling over. Do we have any other cool things we can show the people? Okay, so as of like yesterday, I think this is going to be a collaboration with Muzzy. This is like, I say this, and people are going to be like, oh, it's definitely a collaboration with Muzzy. It might be. We'll see if we can make it work. And it's probably going to change a load because, hey, Vinny. No date yet. I should have finished it today. I didn't even, So here's some heavy shit. Oh, actually, I had to go to an older version of that project file because I did some weird shit to it the other day. So, where are you guys all from? Where are you viewing from? I'm really curious to see who's, like, up at this time and who's, like, free, because you know, me doing this at 7 o'clock UK time means that it's many other times around the world. And if I want to do this again for, like, say, people in America, it might be a case that they're not on right now. So Leeds, very close by. This is something new. Fucking to all of the plugins need to realize how late they're gonna be. So that sounded like entirely out of tune and like entirely out of time, and like I have no idea what I'm doing. But I promise you I have some idea what I'm doing. There we go. That's a cool sound, I should save that. Turn that down. Basses. What's everybody been listening to recently? What artist is everybody digging right now? Like, I wanna hear about some cool new tracks. That's what we'll do. You guys post some tracks. I'm gonna listen to them and we'll talk about them and see what's up. That's a cool idea. I'm down for that. Let's do that. throw up some links. I nearly choked on the apple. I don't want to listen to my own music anymore right now. I'm kind of done. I'm over it. All right. Come on, Crooked Amber. That's the first one. I haven't heard that one. Wait, you mean Ember? I have heard that one. Yeah. Yeah, I definitely know that one. That's like, didn't that win Track of the Year? I think I was at the Drum and Bass Awards 2 nights ago. And that one won the thing. Probably know this one already, but okay, what's this first track? I'm going in. I've got to plug in the aux chord. Divinity feat. Amy Millen. I don't know this one. I never actually listened to that album. Everyone seems to fucking love it though. I'm gonna make sure that this isn't making any noise. Where's all my sound gone? Why no sounds? Hello? Oh, okay, I can't do it like that. That's fine. 1 second, guys. Right. Oh, no, I don't want to hear my voice. No, fuck. Right. Sekai Tunes, Break the Ice. Let's do that. Because I've already heard a lot of water stuff recently. So this was Alexander Jessamine put this up. I guess this is your track, dude. Is that right? If it is, it's cool. I like it. I think the bass sound choice was nice. The I think the build up might be. No, the build up's fine. I think if you ever make a track similar to this, it would be worth doing something like having a load of extra reverb. Yeah, you add a load of reverb to that lead sound and then compress it. After that, then it'll kind of bring up those tails. You won't take up any more of your mix, but you'll just make that sound sound a load fuller. Jesus, everybody's sending me so many things. Okay, I'm going to go for something that I definitely... okay, what's... no, a lot... We need less EDM. I need less, like, straight-up EDM stuff and things. Rat-a-tat are awesome. But that's not the vibe right now, I don't think. Lemaitre, try and time to realize. Let's go for that. That sounds cool. Lemaitre. Having trouble highlighting things. No, I'm just gonna fucking type it. Time to realize. I'm gonna do my best to avoid any troll tracks that you guys might be sending me, but I know that that's inevitable, that you're only gonna end up sending me to like some fucking YouTube poop or Rickroll. Ooh, this sounds cool. I'm gonna turn around, we've got a music video for this one. Yeah, this is cool, I like this. Oh shit, dude's all fucked up. Sorry about the apple noises. Okay. I like this. I'm going to save this for later. But I'm not going to spend my whole time listening to all of every track, because that would not be... Why can't I use my computer properly? But... Oh yeah, you got... Googling Spotify Luffs. Like, how do I use this? And now that's feedback shit. Oh wait, I need that back. Oh fuck, right. Let's get my Facebook off there a second. Put me back on. There we are. Hey guys. Tiny moving parts caution. What is that? Let's find out. Put you guys back up here. I don't fucking know. Hey. Tiny moving parts caution. What do you guys look for? Like this is like a big, this is a big question. When you guys are listening to music, what is it that you because anybody who's here is some, well, most of you I imagine are people who like this page for whatever reason that may be. When it comes to listening to music or anything, what is it that catches your ear and makes you think, oh, I like this? I'd be really curious to hear what you guys have to say about that, because, yeah, I feel like it's a good discussion. Oh, we got some answers coming in. Close that ad. You're all saying vocals. I like that. Oh, tiny moving parts. Closer. Oh, we got something. I haven't heard anything like this in a long time. I'm cool with that, though. Constantly connecting dots, trying my best. It's new too. It sounds like it's from like 2005. What's done is done. And you cannot change the past. Helping or hurting, I am numb. I haven't felt anything in days. Confusion is key, as I am locked inside. Or am I just really poor Janet. This is tiny moving parts, caution. Yeah, there's some nice parts to this. I like this. This is cool. Whoever said this one, cool suggestion. So a lot of you guys are saying lyrics and vocals. That's really cool. It makes me want to play you guys some stuff that's kind of top secret that we've been working on. And yeah. Okay, so for the last like 2 years or so, I've been working on a lot of tracks, like that are all entirely vocal based. And by that I mean it starts, the vocals are in, and then it doesn't drop, it goes to a chorus. It's like songs, and that's always what I've wanted to be doing. I don't know how many of you know how I got into this, but I originally was in punk bands, playing bass and singing, and that's how I found myself liking songwriting and I guess the process of adding vocals to things and creating whatever arc you want to create with a track. And I've gone back to that, and that's how I've spent the last 2 years. And like, yeah, I've been doing some dubsteppy and housey and drum and bassy stuff on the side, and I still love those. This isn't me saying, oh, I'm fucking done with that. But the place I've always wanted to be is with the vocals and having that be the core, and then everything else kind of being like, oh, I'm going to draw from drum and bass for this one, or I'm going to, let's go kind of rockier on this one, or fucking let's go R&B or something. I'm probably not going to do that, but you know what I mean? Like I like to be able to draw from all the things that influence me. And if I'm using my voice and making tracks like that, then I guess that's a really nice centralized element that makes it mine. And no one can take away that I'm me, I guess, you know, and I do my own vocals, because anybody can produce a track. Like I've seen people go like, you can Google tutorials on how to make a load of my sounds and stuff on YouTube. And people get pretty close a lot of the time. Like production is completely fleeting, you know. Why not play the vocals and just nothing else? There recently, I noticed. So I was working on this is the thing we were working on when I first started this stream. Like, so I was initially just gonna kind of have you here. And I work on my mix down, and I'd be like, occasionally, like, be like, yeah, hey. But this has kind of gone a little bit more off the rails, which is not a problem, because I didn't really want to work on that track all that much more. But I noticed that the vocals altogether sounded kind of cool, so I'll show you that. So recently I've been using this plugin that kind of, instead of doing harmonies, I like to use plugins that do that, because often it's more tight than what you could do with a load of layers. And doing a load of layers is like a totally specific choice that you can make, and it's yeah, it's right sometimes. This is how it sounds in the track. So on. So this is a more droppy kind of track, but one of the ways that I make my vocals sound like they do is I have this thing. Where is it?
Good God, what was the point in all the trouble?
Then you put that with the thing.
If I had any more doubts, I'd take you down.
Right? It's kind of cool.
Good luck, there's never enough left in the bottle.
So there's like,
if I had any more doubts, I'd take you down.
And that's just, you know, that's just me on my own. And so it's just like putting it together to make something that sounds, in my opinion, pretty cool. Where is it? There it is.
Good God, what was the point?
Found a thing that was annoying me. You should have seen me in Aspen. That was a really fun show. Like in terms of So I was on, for anybody who's who doesn't know, I was just recently on tour in America, it was for like 2 months, but I recently played in Aspen. That one was actually like one of the most fun times I've ever had DJing. I was a little bit tipsy, but like in exactly the right place. Like a lot of DJs will tell you there's one place where you're not too drunk to mix well, and you're just drunk enough that you're just going to vibe off it no matter what happens. So you end up surprising yourself and playing stuff that's not so much what you would normally do. But because you're having such a great time, it doesn't really matter. And that was one of those shows. And I remember that really clearly. That was a fun night. I got blood on my shirt that night, actually, because me and Abe jumped in the mosh pit together, and somebody bled on me. Yeah. Rock and roll. Have I ever met infected mushroom? I haven't met infected mushroom, no. It's not called dopamine. It's called take you down. Because it does this. Take you down. You know what's terrifying? I'm prone to fiddling. Like I always need like something to play with my hands, I guess. Like, and it's terrifying to me that I have super glue on my desk nowadays. I know I'm just gonna end up like gluing my hand like this, and I'm never gonna be able to move it again or something. And I should probably put this somewhere further away from me, actually. I do have a fidget spinner. I do. Yeah. Don't we all? Yeah. What do I hear? Remember when I hear hoo-ha? So I'll get the track up, because that'll make a nice little bit of a bed for that. Is it even on here? I'm gonna put the VIP on, fuck it. No. I don't even think I have the MP3 for Hoo-Ha anymore. Not on this computer, anyway. On my DJ computer, but yeah. But yeah, so when I think of Hoo-Ha, I think of the first time I'd ever been put in like a studio session situation that was really short term and with somebody I'd never met before by a label. So this was made at the Spinning Writers Camp, and I'd never met Kirby before in my life. I liked his tracks, they had us put in this little corner. They didn't have us in one of the good studios. They had us on this little two pair of shitty speakers in the corner of this like hall that was supposed to be like the recording room, and we just vibed out. We had a really, really great time. The track got made in about 3 hours. Like, we had the track really fast, and by the end of the day, we'd made the second drop, which is the trappy drop, and we were done. We were away. I timed that kind of well, too. It's one of my favorite clubby tracks I've made, no question. It just works way better than so many other tracks I've made. I did fuck up the low end, though. I take responsibility for that. The low end on it is not as good as it could be. Also, I'm sorry if I offend you with my swearing. I'm a very sweary man. Yeah, it was a supernatural thing. It was just like, it just happened really fast. And then it took us like another month to get like the finalized mixdown stuff done. But yeah, no. Shaq, I see you retweeting. You lurking? Hey, dude, if you're there. Right now, my confidence is at a bit of a high, because and this is totally unrelated to music. I love to cook, and tonight I did for the first time I tried to make fried fish tacos, and they went really, really well. They were really, really nice. So like I'm just sat here feeling like, yeah, I'm the king. I got it. I'm good. You know. And if you've never had fried fish tacos, what are you doing? I found the fidget spinner. Hey Daniel, thanks man. That means a lot. It really does. I'm glad you like my music. it's nice. It's, yeah. Yeah. I found, yeah. I have one of these. Faint has one of these, and a couple of our friends also have one. We all went on holiday to Croatia together this year. This year, yeah. And yeah, we all got fidget spinners, semi-ironically, but I think we all still have them on all of our desks, and yeah. It kind of became a little bit unironic, I guess. I should probably stop playing with it, though. Why is everybody talking about me selling a couch? I'm not selling a couch. I mean... I've tried, you know what, you mentioned all this time, Patrick, yeah, all this time, I'm really proud of that track, and I'm very happy with the existence of that track, and there have been a couple times where I've tried to make something similar, but it's never been quite right. I've never been able to recreate it in the way that I would want to, or well, not recreate, but kind of like, you know, hold on to the things that make that track good whilst also making a track that warrants being a separate track. Yeah, that's never, it's never really worked out completely, but yeah, is for fuck's sake released somewhere in Lossless. Yeah, Beatport, you can buy WAVs on Beatport. Doodle Deadline, oh yeah, I actually did all the doodles for the Kickstarter. If anybody here was a Kickstarter contributor, yeah, I recently did all the doodles for that, so they should be out for you soon. I'm sorry it's taking so long. I'm a terrible human, basically, is what I'm trying to say. What did I expect from the change from Stan SB? I didn't expect anything in particular. The name change didn't change my music directly, but the idea that suddenly I had contacts in America and was able to be on American labels and things like that. That changed my music, and that's not a bad thing. Like, I've learned a lot from a lot of the stuff I've done in America, but yeah, that was definitely a massive influence on how my sound may have changed over the years. Yeah, but hey, I don't regret that. That's, yeah, is Comeback available in Lossless? If my track's on Beatport, it's available in Lossless, definitely. I don't know if Comeback's on Beatport, but I assume it is. Yeah. Oh, is that not on my computer? I've been making loads of like kind of janky new neo soul style beats recently. What was it called? Ah, that's it. Miss You Acoustic in Lossless. I don't know if we're gonna release it or not. I think it's just gonna stay like that video. Sorry. Learn to say it properly first, but I'm actually in Groningen next. I hope I'm saying it right. I'm there next week. I'm there all next week, just kind of chilling out. I like it. It's a lovely city. It's yeah. Which song am I most proud of? It's not out yet. Though I'll play you like 5 seconds of it. I shouldn't do this, but I'm gonna anyway. Fuck it. Yeah, this I'm gonna go soonish because I should probably get back to doing this mix down. But this is the track I'm most proud of. Oh, if I can spell it. This one. Oh shit. Shouldn't play this ever, but hey. Yeah, this is it. This is the track I'm most proud of. She's good to show that you never can tell. Is everybody living a dreamland? Is this dreamland all that we know? Swallow this up in an avalanche and blurring these lines with smoke. Yeah, that's it. Goes like this. It's definitely not headlights. That's not headlights. Yeah, that's something I've been working on for a little while. yeah. There's some really cool shit that I've been working on, and it's why I've been kind of quiet for the last, I don't know, like, social media-wise, it's why I've been kind of quiet for the last 2 years almost, is because I've been working really hard, and I've got a lot to show for it, I think. And it's more than just music that I've been working on. But yeah. Matt Kirby, what? Okay, so the question was, did I ever study music? What would I recommend to a young person after finishing school, or you know, or any young person who wants to get into music? I recommend just fucking do it. That's all I can recommend. Because if you want to do music, you will do music. You'll stay at it, and you'll care, and you'll make stuff, and it'll suck, and you'll be like, okay, this sucks, and I kind of know it sucks, but I'm also really proud of what it's become and the fact that I made it, and I'm proud of these things that I like about it. That's how you get better. That's still what I'm doing. That's still what anybody I know is doing. You still think that your music kind of sucks, but you know why you like it and why you made it, and that's what you take forward every time you make something new. And eventually you get to a place where other people start thinking it's got good stuff about it, and a lot of other people aren't going to hear the problems that you hear, because eventually you kind of learn to hear those problems as a music producer, because that's your job. And then at that point you are a decent musician. I can't recommend any like courses or studying. I know some people who've come through studying music and it's great, and they know loads of shit about music and it's great. I'm definitely not one of those people. I never studied music. Like, I can have a conversation with somebody who did at this point, because I know at this point, I think pretty much what a major 7 is or something, but I had to learn that kind of by doing, as opposed to being told, hey, it's this note, and it's the relationship between this note and this note. Yeah, it changes. It changes from person to person what you need to learn, what you need to be told, and what you need to find out. But what I will recommend to anybody who wants to become a producer, and I mean a producer, somebody who can make their own tracks from scratch in whatever way they want to, don't spend too much time on YouTube tutorials that tell you how to get the sound. Spend time with any kind of tutorial that makes you challenge the things that you think you should do, so that you can learn why you do them, right? It's better to learn, like, those YouTube tutorials, I feel like what they do is they teach you how to... They teach you the route to something else, but they don't teach you how to drive the car, which is the analogy I use when I talk about that sort of stuff. That's what I would say. The couch auction. What is this couch auction, guys? What's going on? I need to know. This is kind of freaking me out a little bit. How long have I been singing for? Long time. Oh, Parkinson White fucking rules. Big up. I'm gonna put some Parkinson White on. Hoo-wee. that didn't work. Parkinson White. If you haven't heard of Parkinson White, he fucking Man is hot. Man's hot. you know, it's an old one, but I'm gonna put on like my favorite Parkinson White tune because it's fucking sick. When I find it. I hope you didn't take it down. This is it. Woo! Sick tune. I've been singing for a while. I don't know. That's on my face. I've been singing forever. But I still don't feel like I'm a great singer. It's a muscle. You just have to be regular. This is 3 years old. This is older than Future Bass is. Like, this guy was doing this shit before it even was a thing. Parkinson White, anybody who's gonna ask. What's he been working on recently? Second drops are a weird one. It depends on how the track is. Oh, that's cool. The reason that the drops on my new EP were generally not that different was just because I felt like they were quite hooky, like Miss You, the melody. I didn't want to do something different from that on the second drop because that melody is kind of the point of that track, you know? What's up? Will I ever do any more house? Yeah, totally. I'll do everything. Like, I like, one of the things that I want to kind of encourage for anybody who listens to my music is to kind of try and see past what genre maybe you came to me through. Like, I know there's people who might be here right now who listened to a lot of house music and may have heard me through any of the house tracks I did, or drum and bass, or dubstep, or whatever else it is that you know me for. But don't be afraid of the other stuff I do, because it, at the end of the day, it all comes from the same place, and I try and still tell the same stories with them, just through different kind of structures and ideas and things. And so when I make the decision for a track to be a dubstep track, it's because I want it to be, and that's why that track has to be how it is. I mean, that's entirely romantic and possibly a little bit indulgent, but aren't we all? What do I say about 2018? 2018 is the year that has to be the... Well, not... I'm not going to say, like, oh, it's my year. Because every year's everybody's year. But 2018, there's a lot of stuff that's due to happen that we've been working on since maybe 2016. 2017 was like a prep year. And I really hope that 2018 is able to reflect the amount of work that myself and a lot of other people have put into the projects that I've been involved in. Maybe it will, maybe it will be reflected, maybe it won't. But hey, we've had a lot of fun doing it, and I guess that's more important, right? The airplane one, I'll put that on. That one's kind of fun. I made a second, talking about second drops being different, the second drop on that one's totally different. It's called Bouncy Mouse at the moment. I don't know why it's called that, but that's what it's called. This is a kind of slightly dubsteppy thing I was working on recently. I have no idea what to do with though, because I don't really want to put a vocal on it, but I also don't want it to just disappear. I don't know. And I need to kind of put a vocal on things. I like that one. But yeah, second drop's kind of cool. I prefer the second drop. right now, this track's in a weird place because I do this thing on the last build-up after the second drop where I change the chords up and I really like it, but it needs like so much more care. Not so much more care and kind of massaging into the track, but I never played this out this bit. That's what happened. But I mean, like, everybody, this is the thing, is it's hard to know what your best tracks are going to be and what's worth finishing and what's not. I make maybe a track a day, not like a full track, but I make a statement of a track, like, you know, it's got maybe an intro or a drop or the things it needs to be to kind of say, hey, this is a track I should be, but you haven't done all the work on it yet. It's really hard to decide where your efforts should go. And maybe I shouldn't, but I always play out ideas that are at this level where I can get a feel for what people think of them when I play them out. And it also means that when I play a DJ set, I can keep a lot of my own flavor in there, even if I'm playing other people's tracks, which happens. Yeah. Hey, be nice, Simon. I'm feeding with Zoe now instead. Yeah, the thing is I make a lot of music and I probably do forget about a lot of tracks that maybe are better than the ones I do release, but it's up to labels as well, and it becomes this giant miscommunication. And I wouldn't want to do what Savant does, which is just release everything, because it makes anything that you make that is really good seem trivial, because you release so much music that it's not a commodity, you know? Or it is a commodity. It's just not rare enough to seem like something worth having, you know? Yeah. How do I decide if a track deserves vocals or not? It's not a case of deserving. Often I'll know from the beginning if a track's going to be vocally or not. Like, and that's because I start hearing the vocals really early on in the track's like design. When I was playing earlier, for example, I'll show you what it sounds like without vocals, and you'll be like, "Oh, it needs vocals." 2 seconds. How many unfinished tracks do I have? Upwards of like 450 or something. There's like a folder that's got all of my like idea fragments in it, and sometimes I go through that and think, oh shit, I should finish that, and then finish that. But right now, yeah, something like 450. So in terms of when I choose to add a vocal, this is the section in this track that should have a vocal. It's nice and atmospheric, but it's not interesting. It's got room for there to be something up front. And usually that's where I'll decide, hey, we need a vocal. Then we get the mic out. And then, you know, when you add them, you end up with something that's, I think, a lot more human. Ever produced for vocalists other than myself? Yes. So recently, and I feel like this went under the radar, and I mean, like, we didn't push it or anything. There's a girl group in Korea called Twice, and I produced a track off their new album. Sounds like this. Because it's all in Korean. I have no idea what they're saying.
Oh!
strange hearing people sing over your own track. I'm probably going to do more K-pop as well, like, so you should look out for that. It's fun. It's just like, make something crazy and give it to Koreans. Bing, bing, bing. Bing, bing, bing. What is that? No. I'm actually working on another K-pop thing at the moment. There's another thing I'm producing right now that's K-pop. But it's like, it's not done. It's really heavy. This is more like a boy band sort of vibe. I guess we're gonna have, like, you know, some Korean boy bandy things happening over that, some formation dancing and whatever. If it makes it, like, it's all about, like, what the company want at the end of the day, and if they want to use that track, which they don't have to. I think I might go in a minute. I should probably get back on that mix down. And this, as much as this was supposed to distract me, I think it's distracting me more than I had bargained for. Has anybody seen The Disaster Artist yet? I really want to see that, and I haven't yet. Is it good? Right. What's this? I'm just going through my project files at this point. Contest, it's not just up to me, I imagine. I imagine it's up to what the label want to release, etc., etc. But yeah, I'm probably gonna go. I think I should probably get back to doing this mix down while my ears are still kind of like working for the rest of the day. And then I'll do something else after. But yeah, thanks for DNB Symbols. How fucking years takes years. It's so hard. I mean, like, this track sounds like, the drums in this track sound like this. Drum and bass drums are the hardest drums to make out of any genre, no question. The thing is, they sound like... doesn't sound that great on its own. And that's part of the problem. It's like, you do that and then you put it in the track and it's like... makes loads of sense. But you get the idea. I should get back to doing this mix down because... otherwise, we don't have any tracks to release, and then you guys don't get any music that hopefully you'll at least like a little bit. I'll play it again. I'll play the track I've been working on just one more time, just because, you know, it's good to share, right? Thank you guys for coming to hang out, though. This was nice. Alright, so this is called Take You Down, and it's probably going to be not my next release, but it's soon. It's like a soon release. I know that I say that a lot.
I'm excited about this one. I'm proud of this one. That doesn't happen that often. Here, this one. Keep calm, what's that supposed to mean? If I had the chance, then I'd crash and burn. It's got really shitty guitars in it. The dopamine. I do my best, but I never learn. You get the idea. It sounds a bit like that. The second drop's kind of the same, except it's got like a little bleepy melody in it, but it's basically the same thing. Yeah. I think I'm gonna go. It was cool hanging out with you guys. I'm gonna do this more often. Just come by and say hi whenever you feel like it, if I'm on. And you guys, what day is it? It's Thursday. Have a good weekend. I'll see you when I see you guys. And yeah, keep being cool. Keep being you. Keep being real, etc., etc. Yeah. Should I accidentally play something I shouldn't? No, I should not. That would not be okay. All right. Bye, guys. I'm out. Have a good one. Bye.